The end of austerity and what it really means. Last week, the IMF and its sister institute, the World Bank, held their annual meetings in Washington, D.C. Virtually all countries in the world are member states of these two entities, although its voting shares are distributed in such a way that developed countries have a majority. When it comes to the economic policies countries should adapt, these two entities can be seen as the supreme priesthood of the established wisdom, the architects of the global financial system. Last week, the economic gurus of the IMF and the World Bank had a dramatic change of mind. After decades of preaching prudent fiscal management, the recommendation, in fact for many the obligation, to balance public expenses with taxes, countries are now told to spend heavily and to raise massive debts to finance that spending, ignoring, for now, repayment issues. Yes, sir. Now, what is suddenly the new plan of our economic policymakers? Well, right now the world economy is characterized by an excess of savings over investments. Thus, global interest rates are likely to remain very low. Given such low rates, the debt growth rate is likely to remain lower than the growth rates of countries' economies, provided countries spend enough on their economies. So there you have the new plan of the policymakers. If you spend, your economy might grow faster than your debts. If you don't spend, your economy will shrink. And, in fact, there is a bigger risk that your debts blow out of proportion compared to your shrinking economy. What does that mean for our investments? Well, low interest rates and modest economic growth remain an interesting combination for high-quality growth stocks. Sometime down the road, however, perhaps 3 to 4 years from now, either wages and prices will rise and thus interest rates will go up, or the recession will be such that governments will need to raise more taxes, also on successful corporations, so as to redistribute to families. Either way, this will start to look nasty for the returns on all financial assets, be they bonds or equities.